So, hello, good morning. So, okay, good morning, and okay, and thank you very much for joining this webinar, where we will speak about how your company could benefit from the advantages of the cable robotics technology. The webinar will take 1 hour and a half. We will make the presentation of approximately 1 hour, and then we will have approximately half an hour for questions. Please write your questions in the field called written preguntas. And we will answer your questions after the presentation. This webinar will be recorded, and then we will send you the link with the video that will be available at the Technalia YouTube channel. We will also share with you the presentation explaining this webinar. And we will repeat that, but if any of you are interested in visiting the facilities of Haso or the facilities of Technalia, you are invited. So in this webinar, okay, we are three speakers, Raúl Fernández from Haso. He is the Sales and Marketing Director of Haso Industrial Cranes. Pierre Liger is Mechanical and Control Engineer at Technalia. He is an expert in cable robotics, and he has been working in the technology for more than 10 years. And myself, Mariola Rodríguez, Industrial Engineer and Project Manager at Technalia, and I've been also working in the cable robotics technology for more than 10 years. Haso is our industrial partner to bring the cable robotics technology to the market. Please, Raúl, explain briefly your company and yourself. Raúl? Yes, Raúl, we cannot hear you. Hello, Raúl. Raúl, can you hear us?
Yes, okay. Hello, good morning. Well, first of all, thank you everybody for coming to our webinar. Yes. Our target for today is to show you our capabilities and all the details related to the cable robotics technology and how to apply it to the different solutions in different industries. In my case, I belong to Haso Group, to Haso Industrial Cranes. Haso Industrial Cranes is the, well, Haso Group is a group of companies within the lifting industry focused during the last 65 years in providing solutions in the lifting industry, in the industrial sector, and also in the building sector. We were born in 1965 in the Basque Country, in the north of Spain, close to San Sebastian, to the French border. And yeah, in some years we developed also our own technology applied to the tower cranes for the building industry. Nowadays we are present in more than 60 countries, okay? And with our own facilities in Spain, Mexico, Argentina, and lifting solutions for all the different type of industries worldwide. We are leaders in the lifting industries in the industrial cranes division. Not only in the domestic market, but also in the different markets worldwide. Within our product range, okay, different lifting solutions, we divide three different product lines. The first one is light duty cranes for industrial applications, design and manufacture our own white rope hoist with different lifting capacities up to more than 100 tons. The second big product range are the process and technological cranes, mainly focused on the iron and steel industry, with abilities for designing and manufacture and install different cranes up to more than 500 ton capacities for the different processes of the steel industry. Mm-hmm. And the third product, the customized solutions, like in which we can apply the different solutions from our engineering department to the different customer needs. We are present in, as we have said, in more than 60 countries, and with a total turnover of around 70 million euros per year and a production capacity of more than 1,000 cranes per year, we are employing more than 500 people worldwide. Okay. So now going directly into the CraneBot application.
Sorry.
Mariola will introduce the technology company.
Yes, I will just say a few words about Tecnalia. Hope you know about us. So Tecnalia is the largest applied research and technological development center in Spain. We are a European benchmark, and we are member of the Basque Research and Technology Alliance. Our scope of actions are aligned with the Sustainable Development Goals. With a multi-sectoral and multi-technological perspective, we listen and work with companies to respond to the major global challenge. And in this way, we are able to generate profit for companies and create value for society. We are around 1,500 people, working in many sectors, as you can see in the slide. My colleague Pirelli and myself work in the field of smart manufacturing, and in particular in advanced machines, automations, and robotics. So okay, along this presentation, yes.
Yes. Yeah, and going directly to the cable robotics technology, and talking about, let's say, which is the origin of the needle. So some years ago we discussed and we have different conversations with Tecnalia about how to, let's say, industrialize one solution for large industries applying the cable robotics technology into a crane. So we developed our first units around 4 years ago, okay? And the needing came from the main industries, not only in the area, but also in different international environment, about how to automate the operations within the different production processes. So we took the goal, okay, and we applied the cable robotics following the Tecnalia guidelines into our light duty cranes for having one, let's say, device that could, let's say, in one hand to give an accurate precision in certain processes, and on the other hand to lift and to move heavy components in the different industries. So the main goal was to also to handle in large areas, large work spaces, these big pieces, okay? And as a result, we applied the cable robotics to one of our light duty cranes, one of our models, and we get a very cost effective and versatile solution to automate the operations. And of course, we could also work in manual mode in the different modes of the cranes, okay? And mainly what we achieved was to offer to the different industries different perspectives in different sectors in order to generate more added value to the different processes of each industry. So mainly focus in precision for automation in some parts of the process, and accuracy in movement of big pieces or some processes related to big pieces. Okay. So the main advantages that we get with this solution is the first of all the flexibility and versatility, and in order to to get more accurate movements and more accurate solutions to the different processes. It's a solution that it's suitable for indoor and outdoor applications that we will see later with during the Mariola explanation, in which you will see different applications even in solutions under the water. It's very precise, so we will be able to give accuracy to certain existing applications in which nowadays we are using manual modes or different operators. And of course we can apply also versatility in terms of customize some automations of operations that currently are let's say executed by the different production centers in the customer solution. So as a result, we improved the plant safety, of course. We have in one hand the, let's say, the capacity of the hoist and the accuracy of the winches in the lateral sides of the crane bot. Okay, so safety, productivity, we can increase the productivity with more accurate processes. And of course, savings, because only one operator is required to control the cable robot. And yeah, and we have explains an accuracy of 1-2 centimeters and 1-2 millimeters in repetitive processes.
Okay, so okay, regarding the technology. Okay, Tecnalia, okay, 20 years ago, Tecnalia developed a parallel kinematic robot. It was called Quattro Robot. And okay, we licensed the patent to an industrial company called ADET, and now it's ADET who is commercializing this kind of robot. Then we moved from parallel kinematic robots to cable-driven parallel robots. The technology is very similar. Okay, we have just changed the rigid bar by cables. And yes, and bueno, this is one of the product that we have and that we will explain. So the cable-driven parallel robots are able to position any load precisely in large workspaces by controlling the length and the tension of the cables in a synchronous way. Here on the slide, okay, you can see the different components of the cable robot. So we have the winches. In the cable robot that the cable robots that we develop include 8 winches with 8 cables. We can decide which is the position of the winches. The winches are composed by the motor with its encoder, a gear, and a drum. Then we have the pulleys. We can also decide which is the right location for the pulleys. And the aim of the pulleys is to guide the cables from the winches to the mobile platform of the robot. The mobile platform, is the part where we attach the grippers, the sensors, the head that we need in order to make any applications, any operations that we need. So the mobile platform, the 8 cable are attached to the mobile platform. We are able to control the 6 degrees of freedom of this mobile platform. That means that we are able to control the 3 displacements, Z, X, and Y, and also the 3 rotations. And all the components that are attached to this mobile platform also have this 6 degrees of freedom. The industrial controller that we are using are 2, B&R Automation and Becov. As Raúl has said, one of the advantages of this technology is the versatility. And thanks to the capability, we can develop many applications for different industry. And these are the applications that we have developed up to now. These are the applications that we are going to explain you along this webinar. And okay, we hope to inspire you and to think about in which other application of your interest could be this technology be used and be suitable. So along this presentation, we will explain you the use of cable robot for the automated sanding of wind turbine blades for the energy sector. Also the automated or semi-automated handling of bus and body sidewalk panels for the bus and coach sector. We also show you how to perform desert tasks in confined spaces by mounting a robotic arm on the mobile platform of the robot, and that can be used for different applications and for different sectors, drilling, painting, welding, in different sectors. Another application is the advanced logistic optimization, where we have integrated vision system and artificial intelligence. Another one is for the aeronautical sector, where we have developed a solution for semi-automated handling and assembly of sheet metal plates in its corresponding machine or support. And in these applications, we have to deal with with hundreds of references of pieces that have to be manipulated. Another sector is the construction sector, and we have developed 2 applications. One is additive manufacturing of building components on an industrial scale using cable robotics, and the other one is the semi-automated assembly and maintenance of building facades, also with a cable robot, but in this case the cable robot reaches a very large vertical surface. And the last application is quite different. It's an application of the cable robotics for underwater operation. So in this case, what we wanted to do is to eliminate marine litter, mainly plastics, that was in the seabed using cable robot. Okay, this cable robot is mounted on a floating platform, and we will explain you with more detail this application. And this is for marine environment. Okay, another advantage of the cable robots is their flexibility. As I have said before, that we can't decide where to put the winches and where to put the pulleys. So doing that, we can create different cable robots in multiple configurations. Here you can see Kojiro robot. In this robot, the winches are in a fixed position. We have 8 winches. Okay, they are on the bottom of this reticular extractor. And the pulleys are placed here on the top of this extractor, and the pulleys are guiding the cables from the winches to the mobile platform. This prototype is in Montpellier, in our facilities in Montpellier. It's 15 meters length, 11 meters width, and 6 meters high, and the payload capability that we have is 500 kilo. Here you can see on the right, okay, you can see that in this prototype we have integrated a head. This is a head for 3D printing. It's just an example of what we can integrate in this mobile platform. Okay, another possibility is, okay, to put the winches and the pulleys on a crane. And this product is called CraneBot. A CraneBot shows the advantages of the crane, because the crane provides very very big payload capability and also a large workspaces with the capability of the cable robots. That, in this case, they provide the 6 degrees of freedom control and accuracy. So these are an interesting product that we think could be useful for many applications in your industries. Another configuration is the one that you can see here. It's called Maelstrom. In this case, the winches are fixed and are mounted on this on these columns. We have for this prototype we have 4 columns and 2 winches per columns. In this case, the pulleys are mounted on a movable vertical carriage. So we can also change the position of the pulleys, okay? And we have to do that because we wanted to work at a depth around 20 meters below the sea level. So in order to get high stiffness, working at 20 meters depth, okay, we have decided to design this reconfigurable cable robot. And another example of prototype that we have developed is this one. We have developed it under the project Hephaestus. It's a European project, and in this case we are working in the construction sector, and we are reaching very high surfaces, but vertical surfaces. The aim of this prototype is to make the assembly of these facade panels in semi-automatic way. In this case, the winches, okay, we have also 8 winches. Okay, 4 winches are located here, two in this position, in this structure, and in this position, another 2 here, and the other 4 are on the floor. And we have also put the pulleys in the position, in the right position, in order to get the working space that we need to cover all the building surface. So here you can see, you could have an idea of some of the configurations that could be got with this technology. These are some examples. These are the prototypes that we have developed up to now, but these are not the only possibilities that the technology has. So, okay, as I have said, okay, so a CraneBot is a flexible robotic crane. What we are doing with CraneBot is we are transforming the crane into robotic systems. And as I have said, we are summing the advantages of the crane with the advantages of the cable robotics technology. In this product, the hoist, the main hoist of the crane, can work in synchronization with the mobile platform of the robot. So if we need to handle a very large, very heavy parts, we can use the hoist capacity of the crane. So in order to do that, we fix a cable, we fix the hoist cable to the mobile platform, and we develop the red control in order to be able to pick and manipulate larger objects. 6 degrees of freedom in the mobile platform. We can be precise in the movement, and we can integrate in this mobile platform any component that we need. Here you can see that there is a sanding head for the wind turbine blades, but we could integrate here any kind of sensor, any kind of gripper, any kind of head that you need for your application. Here you can see better the components of CraneBot. So we have the crane. This crane has a secondary bridge. Here you can see also the hoist of the crane, and you can see that the hoist of the crane can be attached or not to the mobile platform of the cable robot. We have the winches are embarked on the crane, but you can see here, and also the pulleys are also embarked. This is the mobile platform, and the electrical cabinet of the whole equipment is also embarked here. Regarding the control, in this case, the industrial controller is from B&R Automation. We have also developed an easy to use user interface that is suitable for installation in mobile devices. And this robot we can operate the robot in automated mode. So in that way, we can program point-to-point linear movement, and we can also execute a G-code program in a CNC module, and we can also control the crane manually with a remote controller. Here in the slide, below in the slide, you can see a photo, the radio controller with the tablet, and that make the use of the control of the robot easier to the operator, because they can't control manually with the radio controller, and they can switch to the automated mode just pressing one button, and with the user interface implemented in this tablet, you can program and execute the saved trajectories. As I have said before, the main hoist can be fixed to the mobile platform of the robot or not. That depends on the load to be handled. Okay, so if you want to manipulate loads bigger than 2 tons, you need to join the hoist to the mobile platform. Otherwise, okay, you can just use the cable robot, and you see the payload capacity of the cable robot that is around 2 tons. Yes, and here you will see a video of the system, and here you will have the opportunity to see the different movements of the CraneBot system. The displacement, the 3 displacement that we have, and also the rotation capabilities that we have. Okay, we can play with the rotations by changing the design of this mobile platform. So imagine that if an application is interesting to get high rotation in X direction. Okay, we can design the mobile platform, and we can decide which are the position of these location points, the fixing points between the cables and the mobile platform. We can decide where these points are. We can change the design of the mobile platform, and in that way, we can adapt the rotation of the cable system to your application and to your requirements. With the radio controller, we can control all the degrees of freedom of the crane, not only the degrees of freedom associated to the cable robot, but also to the crane. Okay, so all the movement of the crane and of the cable robot are controlled by the same PLC and also by the same radio controller. Now, okay, we are going to explain you the first applications that we have developed. Is for the automated sanding of windmill blades. And okay, we wanted also to explain you how we work in most of the cases. Okay, we know that the cable robotics is an innovative technology, is and now by most of the industrial customers, and most of the potential customers prefer to validate first the use of the technology and its impact in solving the problems to be tackled for the specific application using the existing prototypes that we have, that Hasso and Tecnalia have, okay? Cranebot, Cogiro, Maelstrom, okay, before doing the investment to implement the solution in their factory. This is the normal way that we work. And to reach this same, Hasso and Tecnalia design and build mockups to replicate the X scenario and the real manufacturing conditions and requirements as defined by the customer. So here in these photos, you can see the scenario that we have replicated. The objective is to automate the sanding of this wind blade. Okay. You know that the wind blade has a complex shape. So first of all, we have to program the movement of the robot in order to follow to follow well the shape of the blade. Here, you will see a video. Okay, during the sanding. Okay, the advantages of automating the sanding process in this large part is that we guarantee all the time the safety. Okay, there is only just one operator needed in order to control the process, no more, just one operator. In this case, we are automating operations that are toxic for the workers. In the photos below, you can see how the operators are dressed nowadays in order to avoid to breathe the toxic particles from the sanding blade. Also, if we automate these operations, we ensure the uniformity and the quality of the surface. We reduce the work accident and the risk of skeletal muscles injuries. As you can see, okay, we have got very fine trajectory tracking. You can see that the movements are accurate. Okay, we have programmed complex trajectory in order to follow all the surface of the blade. And doing that, we are able to increase the productivity by 50%. And just to say that this solution is flexible and we can be adjusted to different sizes and models of blades. Another application is this one for the bus and coach sector. In these applications, the aim was to automate or semi-automate the manipulations of coach and both sidewalk panels. And this application has been developed under the European project Penelope. So in this application, BDL is the customer. So in this application, what BDL wants was to validate the cable robotics technology for the automatic and semi-automatic manipulation of the bus sidewalk panels from the horizontal to the vertical plane and also vice versa, from the vertical plane to the horizontal plane and the assembly of the door. We also have to make the assembly, to pick the door and to make the assembly of the door in these sidewalk panels and also the assembly of the whole sidewalk panel with the door to the chassis. So as you can see here, we have also designed and built a mock-up to replicate the scenario and the real manufacturing condition and requirements as defined by the customer, in this case BDL. And we have also designed the gripper that we need in order to perform this operation. This gripper is reconfigurable, okay, because we need to pick and place sidewalk panels and doors of different sizes. And okay, we have integrated also vision vision cameras to pick and locate automatically the sidewalk panels in the different support. And okay, thanks to this gripper, we are able to manipulate seven references of doors and five references of sidewalk panels. And I will give the floor to my colleague Pirelli, and he will go on explaining this application.
Okay, thank you, Mariola. So I will continue to explain this application. I will be a bit faster because the time is running fast. So here you will see the video. So yeah, the first in this process, the sidewall panel must be moved in different supports. The first one is horizontal, so the platform does a circular movement to rotate the panel. And at this step in the Penelope project, there is many tasks of cleaning and preparation of the panel that is performed automatically by other mobile autonomous robots in order to glue the window. After that, the panel is put back at vertical position and moved to the first support. So yeah, the gripper is equipped with a device that strongly maintains the panel to avoid any oscillation, and you can see in the movement that the panel is very rigid with the platform. And then the platform is picking the door. There is a camera, you can see here in the video, the camera that detects the exact position of the doors and pick it and then move to the sidewall panel to insert the door. When this is an automatic process, but the assembly, the final fixing of the door is made manually by an operator. After that, the gripper is one more time reconfigured to pitch again the panel, and then the panel is moved to the next support for the next step of the assembly. So yeah, you can see the movement is very smooth. The assembly is efficient, very quick, is accurate. And the need of accuracy for this application is around 1 centimeter. So for this application, the territory must be adapted for 7 doors and 5 sidewall panel references. So depending on the panel size, the position of the C brackets. The C brackets are the metal part that hold the panel. So these C brackets are in different positions depending on the size of the panel. And the picking and placing position of the platform is different. So elementary G-code trajectory for each case are stored in the memory of the robot. And the operator in the HMI just need to choose the model to build, and all corresponding trajectories are automatically selected and executed in the right order. Also, there is a possibility to interpose manual operation between automatic sequences. And the picking and placing position can be obtained just by teaching functionality or by using camera to locate this position automatically. What we can say that in any application, specific development can be developed for a specific application for a specific process. Because with a BNR environment of development, we can do what we want. There is no limit of development. The benefits of TrainBot system for this application is a reduction of 75% of handling time, which is very high. And it increased the prediction rates. There is only one operator needed for this application, and this reduced the risk of skeletal muscle injuries by 95%. Another application we are working on with Potes Aeronautic Company is the loading and unloading of metal sheets in a machine. There is 100 of references possible to handle, and the goal is not to automate all the process, but just implement a semi-automated process to clearly improve the manipulation and machine loading unloading process, and to enable the process with only one operator rather than two. So one more time, you can save time, improve the production rate, and reduce the risk of musculoskeletal disorder and so on. Here is another application to stay in the aeronautical sector. You can see an application of riveting of composite fuselage. So this riveting head was initially mounted on a robotic arm that operates on the side of the fuselage, and with the cable robot, it's also possible to operate at the top of the fuselage. The weight of the platform is 450 kilo, and we can rotate in all the direction to adapt the shape of the fuselage. So you can see that the robot can follow the path of the fuselage by rotation by plus and minus degree of rotation around the fuselage. With another type of platform, if we change the design, we can also increase again the rotational capacity. So here, you can see the riveting head that automatically drill and rivets the fuselage. There is vacuum cups that is clamped. Maximus is clamped to the fuselage with a vacuum cup, and then the drilling and riveting process can begin. And Yeah, the process is repeated over several tangential coordinates until the riveting is done on the wall rim. We can see also in this image that we can directly connect the cable to a part of the plane to be mounted directly in the plane. You don't need a platform. This is a concept. We never did it in real in the factory, but it is also possible to adapt the control of the cable robot by just fixing directly the cable on the parts to be moved. Another application is the measurement of volume of aggregate into a silo. So this application has been developed with Vicomtech in Arreposa in the Basque Country. And the goal was to measure the volume of aggregates. This is a big need in this field to know the exact available stock in real time. So we use a LIDAR. I will show you the video. We mounted a LIDAR in the platform, and by measuring by scanning all the surface of the area, we can measure the volume, the available stock in real time. We have measured that there is only 3% of error compared to the reality, so it's a very good solution, and you can save time because you don't need to load and upload the grain into trucks to measure the volume. So it's much faster and much more efficient. We can use crane bots or Kojiro system depending on the building. And we can adapt it easily to a building. Then I will show you another application that we developed in by Technalia and the LIRM. It's a laboratory in Montpellier in the DexterWide project. We mounted a robotic arm, which is a Yaskawa SEA 28, under the platform, and we mounted on this Yaskawa several tools like a driller, cutter, some stuff like that, and we made several demos in this application. So the first application was to drilling the concrete block located in an area difficult to be reached. So here you can see that the big translations are made by the platform, the robotic platform, and the small dexterous movements are made by the robotic arm. And the robot is able to drill easily. This system could be used in, for example, in the nuclear sector for dismantling the big area that are contaminated. And by using this kind of robot, we can help to dismantle the concrete area. And here you can see that we go under a surface. That, so this is an area very difficult to be reached, and with the robotic arm, we can reach it. Yeah. And the accuracy of the positioning accuracy can be also very good by a few millimeters. Yeah. A second application with this robot is the path following cylinder. It was to simulate the, for example, the painting of the fuselage of a plane or something. And here in this application, we follow the wall surface. We can cover the wall surface of the cylinder without moving the parts. And we worked a lot on the synchronization of the cable robot plus the robotic arm, because there is many degree of freedom to manage. There is 7 degrees of freedom for the arm and 6 degrees of freedom for the platform. So it was 13 degrees of freedom to synchronize, and we developed the main part of the project was about the synchronization of this and this movement. It could be also for inspection, for many other tasks. And here you can see that the robot follows very well the cylinder. Yes. Okay. We can imagine also to mount this kind of arm into a cranebot system for automatic welding of ship modules in a confined space. So in shipbuilding sector, there is many applications that we can do with a cable robot, and I will let Mariola to continue with this sector.
Okay, so yes, another application for the ship building that we are developing right now. Okay, we are also doing it in the European project Penelope, and in this and in this application. Okay, here the objective is the target component is a modular supply tray that comprise the piping, the heating, ventilation, air conditioning, and all the electrical wiring that are designed to conduct various utilities and systems throughout the ship. And it is fabricated in a modular way in the shipwards. Here we are developing the robotic solution for the efficient pick and place of the piping components onto a customized supply tray. You can see here the different components for the demo, the demo cup that we have designed. This application is ongoing, so what we can show you is this simulation, this CAD simulation. This is what we will be able to show you in the following weeks. So for this application, we have designed a gripper. This gripper needs to have a rotation capability of 90 degrees because we have to pick the support. And we also need to pick the pipes. And we need this 90 degree rotation of the gripper to be able to pick different parts. The pipes are, some of the pipes are made of steel and others are made of plastic. The geometry of the pipes is different. And as you can see, we are making the pick and place of the support of the pipes, and also we are connected one pipe with the other pipe. This is just another example of application that can be done with this technology. So now we move to the construction sector, and one of the applications that we have developed is 3D printing. As the cable robot can reach very large workspaces, we can be able to print a large part or small buildings with this technology. Here you can see some of the parts that we have printed and that we have shown in Construmat. It's a construction fair in Barcelona. And this one is 2.2 meters height and 5 meters length. We have developed this work with the Institute of Advanced Architecture of Catalonia. And they have provided the printing head, and Tecnalia have provided the cable robot. This is Cogiro robot, the one that we have in our facilities in Montpellier. And thanks that we have integrated a CNC control in the PLC, we are able to program very complex trajectories. And the accuracy and the repetitivity of the robot can be seen easily in this application, because we have to apply one layer and then the same layer in the same position and the other layer and the other layer. Okay. In these applications, the material that we are printing is clay, but we can also do it with concrete, for sure changing the printing head. And the second application that we have developed for the construction sector is the one that I have started to explain you before, is Hephaestus, and we have developed it under the European project Hephaestus. So the objective is to automate or semi-automate the assembly of these facade panels in the building. These facade panels are quite heavy. Around 350 kilos, something like this. And you know that we have to make the assembly just in the facade of the building. So that means risk for the operators, for the workers. Okay, so instead of making the installation manually, if we use a crane like this in order to semi-automate the process, apart from increasing the productivity, what we are going to increase is the safety in the construction in the construction sector. Okay, so this cable robot integrates 8 winches, 8 power sensors, 8 pulleys. Okay, all the time we are controlling the tension in the cables. And we need to assure that the cables have the minimum tension needed to perform the operation, but the tension don't have to reach a value over one figure. Okay, so we need to control which is the minimum tension that we have and the maximum tension that we have in order to be sure that the operation is safe. Okay, so in the mobile platform of this robot, okay, we have designed, built, and integrated this N-Effector. It's a universal robot with different tools that can be seen in the following video. Okay, we have tested this robot in two facilities. First, in Tecnalia facilities at lab level, and then we move all the robot to the facilities of Acciona in Toledo, very close to Madrid in Spain. So here you can see the different components of the prototype. Okay, this is a system. This is an ESpool that we have used in order to guide the power and communication cables to the mobile platform from the electrical cabinet, from the main electrical cabinet. That's okay. It's on the floor. Here you can see the winches with the pulleys with the four sensors in order to know it's every time which is the cable tension, and in order to guarantee the safety of the operation. And in the mobile platform, okay, we have integrated this vacuum pad in order to be fixed to the building. And when it's fixed, okay, this universal robot start performing the operations needed to fix the brackets. Okay, and the facade panels will be mounted on this bracket. But first, we need to fix the brackets to the different floors of the building. And here you can see that we have also integrated the gripper with vacuums in order to pick the facade panel. And okay, we can program the trajectory and we can install these facade panels in the right brackets automatically. Just the last movement of the mobile platform is done manually with the radio controller. This is the electrical cabinet. In this case, Bekov has been the industrial controller selected. And now you are seeing the validation of the prototype at Acciona facilities close to Madrid. With the universal robot, okay, we are making many things, many operations. We are drilling, okay, we are fixing the brackets to the concrete. And once the brackets are well located, okay, we pick the facade panel and we put it in the right locations. There are some operations that are done automatically. It is the large displacement. They are this operation is programmed. But this insertion of the sidewalk panels into the bracket, okay, this last operation or this last movement, this is done manually with the radio controller. Okay, so the advantages is that we can reach high workspaces, but in these applications, okay, the main advantage is that we reduce the risk of this kind of operations. This is very important in construction sector, and also, okay, we reduce the production times. This is also an important point in this for this sector. Okay. We could change the heads that are nowadays integrated in this mobile platform, and we could mount another, so different heads. For instance, if we wanted to maintain these facade panels once they have been installed in the building. Imagine cleaning the panels or solving any damage that the panel has. And the last applications that we wanted to show you is this one. We have developed it under the European project in Maelstrom. It is the robotic seabed cleaning platform. Okay, I have started before to explain it. So, okay, we have 8 winches that are mounted in 4 columns, and you can see here. What we wanted to get is to reach the seabed of shallow waters and to perform operation such as the removal of marine litter, including marine plastics, with a minimum impact on the ecosystem. This is an important point for biologists. If we want to remove plastic from the sea, we have to be careful not to damage the sea, the seabed during this process. We have in this application we have integrated or we have mounted a cable robot on the floating platform, and we are, as in other applications, by controlling the length of the cables in a synchronous way, we are able to locate this mobile platform with accuracy in the working space. This robot is able to work until 20 meters depth, and it integrates two heads, an hydraulic ripper for removing objects until 130 kilos, and also a suction device for smaller and lighter objects. And we have also integrated in this mobile platform the underwater sensors that we need in order to guarantee the safety of the robot and in order to identify where the litter is. I will show you a video to show this prototype working. We have tested this prototype in Venice, first inside the Venice Lagoon at 5 meters depth. And we have removed nearly 2 tons of tires and many other components. Later you will see some photos. And after that, we have moved this prototype to the sea, to the Adriatic Sea, and we have tested it at 15 meters depth. Here you can see the rotation. It's accelerated for sure, but here you can see the rotation capability of the robot, the different grippers. This is the whole equipment, the complete seabed cleaning platform that we have developed and that we have tested inside the Venice Lagoon. The visibility of the water was worse than we expected. We need to develop an image enhanced software in order to be able to visualize easily the objects under the water. We have validated this cable robot for cleaning operations, but we could change the heads and we could change the sensors. And we could use this prototype for other applications. We can make different works underwater, construction works, maintenance works, any operations that you think are needed to be done in ports or in underwater. In this, now you are seeing the testing campaign that we did in the Adriatic Sea, 3 kilometers away from the coast. And here the objective was remove voids that was sunk, and also ropes. We were able to eliminate 800 meters of ropes that belongs to an abandoned mussel farm. the platform, the seabed cleaning platform, integrate Ertica GPS. So what we do in order to position the seabed cleaning platform in the right position is we start from bathymetry maps that has been previously obtained, and then we match the position of the Ertica GPS of the mobile platform with the bathymetry maps, and in that way, we are able to position the robot in the right place. So thanks to this clean robot, we could increase the time of cleaning by 3, and also decrease the cost because we are doing with this kind of robot operations that nowadays only can be done by divers. So for instance, if imagine that there are places that they wanted to identify mines before dragging the seabed, this is a dangerous operation, so it's much better to do this operation with a robot like this one instead of doing it with divers. So this is all from us. So now it's time for questions. I hope that you have enjoyed the presentation. I hope that we have inspired you, and now you have in mind some applications or many applications that you would like to share with us. We'll be delighted to help you. So. Yes, the questions, I am reading the questions. Let me 1 minute. Thank you for the questions first. So Martin Herlov, your question is, how do we know the position of the crane bot? Maybe Pirelli, you can answer.
Yes, the position but is known just with the help of the encoders, and we know the captains, so by reconstructing the by geometry we know the position of the platform. So
yes, this is an indirect way to know the position of the mobile platform, but if it is needed we could have extra sensor or external sensor in order to know where it is. But in the applications that we have shown you, we know where is the mobile platform estimating. Pirelli has explained better. So we take into account the measurement of the encoder. So we estimate the position of the mobile platform. So the second question is, how is the pressure of the sanding paper strip measured? In the application, we haven't measured the pressure. The head that we have used has some
springs.
So we designed the stiffness of the spring and taking into account the pressure that we need to apply to the part, but we had also some part integrated in the wheel that avoid the sanding head to damage the surface. So we are not measuring up to now the pressure directly, but with the design of the sanding head, we avoid damaging the wind blade surface. Okay. Yes, another question is, how can we guarantee the trajectory precision in lock movements with big match load? I suppose cable elasticity will provoke oscillation, and am I right?
No, the cable elasticity will not provoke oscillation, just you will need to adapt to take the consideration of the cable elongation to compensate. So you will need to move a bit more the cable to compensate the elongation of the cable. So in the control model, if you know the mass of the platform, the mass of the payload, the characteristic of the elongation of the cable, you can compensate the elongation. And you can have a great accuracy, even if the diameter of the cable is not very high and there is big elongation. In Kojiro robots, the cable are very small and there is a lot of elongation, and we can compensate quite well the elongation. But there is no oscillation. Yeah, there is an oscillation. If there is a shock, yes, the platform will oscillate, but never happened.
Yes. So regarding another question is, when grinding the wind turbine blade, which is the maximum angle the grinder can reach? Okay, so, the mobile platform that we have shown in the video is too big. I guess you have also think about it. So if we wanted to cover, the whole surface of the blade, we need to change the design of this mobile platform. Okay, so with the current design, the rotation that we have, if I am right, is 25 degrees, something like this. But as I have said, this mobile platform is not the right one for sanding the complete surface. So for these applications, we already have another design that allow us, to sand from one side of the blade to the other side of the blade. So this is also important to take into account that the design of the mobile platform is critical, and also where to attach the cable to the mobile platform. These points are very important from the control point of view, and also for defining which is the rotation capability of your cable robot. I want also to say, if you buy one cable robot, for instance, a CraneBot, you can't change one mobile platform by another, and you can also change the connecting points. Okay, you can do that. In order to do that, you have to check with us if the new connection points or the location of the new connection points are in the right places. We have a configurator in order to check that the robot will work correctly with this new configuration. But just you to know that we can play with those parameters. And as I have said, for the application of the sanding of this blade, the mobile platform that now is built is not the right one, because that platform doesn't provide all the rotation capability that it is needed. Okay, so for this application, it will be needed to use another platform that would allow us to perform the whole grinding of the blade. If there is something not clear, please write again and we try to do it better. Okay, the next one is, which is the maximum movement speed typically of the mobile platform in meters per second?
This is around 1 meter per second. in the most of the case, this is the max speed, but we can go faster just by designing bigger motors or just a bigger drum. It's easy to go faster. In the Kogi robots, we reach maybe 3-4 meters per second in the maximum, but we never need to go as fast. In 99% of the application, you just need to go at 0.5 or 1 meter per second at the maximum.
Okay, so next question is regarding safety. So Jose Antonio Romeo asks, how does the system detect people working in the covered area to avoid safety issues? So regarding safety, okay, what we have to say is that if the robot is working in automated mode, no people can stay in the same working area. Okay, so there are many options in order to avoid people to go inside the working area while the robot is working in automated mode. When you are working with the robot in manual mode, okay, the radio controller, okay, is the operator who has the control of the robot, is the operator who has the responsibility of the safety in the use of the robot. And in the radio controller, is a recommendation is to have in the radio controller the deathman option, deathman button. Okay. You can also add extra sensors or extra vision camera or yes, different sensors in order to detect collisions. This is something that you can do, but the rule is, or the recommendation, and well, the rule is that if the robot is working in automated mode, nobody can be in the working area at the same time as the robot is moving. If the robot is working in manual mode, yes, you can work in the same working area, but in that, okay, but doing that, first you could implement or mount external sensors. But always is the responsibility of the operator of the cable robot to guarantee the safety in this operation. In the user interface, we have developed a user interface and it's very easy to change from automated mode and manual mode. Indeed, many of the applications that we have shown you today, okay, there are some parts of the operation that is done automatically. And dexterous tasks are mainly done manually. Okay, and in order to change from manually to automatically, you just need to press a button in the user interface. So, next question is, which is the maximum speed of movements to avoid inertia and control movements when system stops?
It depends on the payload. If you have 3 tons of payload, for sure you will need to go slower. But we have already experienced that during uncontrolled stop, in an emergency stop, the platform is very rigid, very, very rigid.
Yes. The next question is from Lorea Legazpia. For sanding, it is possible to add a sensor to irregular surfaces, such as different heights. Okay, we can integrate the sensors that the applications require. That's not the problem. We just need to know. We just need to decide which is the right sensor and which is the right location, but we can add different sensors. And so the head for sanding, yes, I would like also to say, okay, we design, okay, the head of sanding that we designed was our own design. We know that in the market there are commercial sanding heads, more advanced than the one that we used. We just wanted to say that with the head that we used, we guarantee that the quality surface during the sanding was maintained. And yes, so we could, so the sanding head could be a more industrial one than the one that you have seen, and it's possible to integrate any kind of sensor. As I have said, we have to select the right sensor and the right location, but yes, we can do it. And yes, the price, which is the price level for the cable robot. But again, it's difficult to answer to that, because that depends on which is the application, which is the site of the cable robot that you need. And I think this question is difficult to answer by us, but by Tecnalia and also by Hasso, because it depends on the specification of the product.
Anyway, if you are interested, we can make a case study and we can somehow study a proposal for one specific application. Okay, so more questions or
Okay, so if there is not more questions, we thank you again very much for joining this webinar. Also thank you very much for your interest, for your questions. You can contact us by email, by phone. After this webinar, we will send you the link of the video of this webinar, as it has been recorded, and we will also share with you the presentation that we shown. And if you have a further question in the future, or if you want us to analyze your applications and to tell you if cable robotics could be a solution for that, please, we'll be delighted to receive your emails, your doubts, your questions, and that. And if you wanted to visit the facilities of Hasso or the facilities of Tecnalia, you are also invited to do it. So please contact us, and thank you very much again for being with us.
Okay, so I think we can close the webinar. Okay, so as Mariola has said, and also Pierre, so thank you very much for your time and interest, and we'll remain at your disposal for any additional question you may raise. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Have a nice day. Bye.
Have a nice day. Bye.